Hello viewers, in this video we shall discuss how to calculate hire purchase transactions when the hire purchaser, that is the buyer, defaults in his payment. If the hire purchaser fails to make any of the payment, any of the installment, and in consequence of that, if the hire vendor is taking the goods completely, how are we going to do the ledger accounts? So what is complete repossession? On default by the buyer, the hire vendor completely takes the goods. That is, he takes back the whole lot of goods that he has sold to the hire purchaser. This is complete repossession. Okay, now let's move on to this video. X Limited purchased a piece of machinery on 1st Jan 1980 on the hire purchase system. The cash price of the machinery was 29,800. Terms of payment were 8,000 half yearly over 2 years, the first payment to be made on 30th June 1980. Rate of interest was 6% per annum. X Limited wrote off 10% depreciation under written down value method. It could not pay the installment due on 30th June 1981, and as a consequence, the hire vendor took possession of the machinery. Give necessary accounts. Okay, this is the question. First, let's understand what are the details that are given in the question. X Limited is the hire purchaser. X Limited purchased the machinery, so it is the hire purchaser. Cash price of the machinery is given, 29,800. Terms of payment, 8,000. Installment amount is given. And the installment amount, the periodicity, the interval between two installment is half years, 6 months period. Then rate of interest is 6% per annum. Depreciation is 10%. It could not pay the installment due on 30 June 1981. So the hire purchaser has defaulted in a payment. So what happened? The hire vendor took possession of the machinery. One machinery has been sold and the machinery has been taken back by the hire vendor on default. So this is a complete repossession problem. So before moving on to this repossession calculation, first let's calculate interest. So for this interest calculation, I have uploaded a separate video which explains interest calculation in detail. If you have not watched that video, the link I have given it in the description box. Do watch that video. Here I'll just quickly go through the interest calculation. In this problem, cash price is given, installment amount is given, and rate of interest is given. So we are calculating interest as per the first method. They are given 5 columns. Particulars column, outstanding balance, installment, interest, cash price, paid. 5 columns. And we are starting our answer with the cash price. Writing the amount in the outstanding balance because the total cash price is pending. The buyer has to pay the total cash price to the seller. Normally, down payment is the first payment. We will deduct that. But in this problem, there is no down payment. So we are skipping the down payment. And the first payment that is made by the hire purchaser to the hire vendor is the first installment amount. The first installment amount that is given in the question is 8,000. So I am recording it in the installment column. Now we have to calculate interest. Interest is calculated on the outstanding balance. The outstanding balance is 29,800. On that we are applying 6%. 6% is the rate of interest. So I am applying 6%. And I am doing this 6 by 12. Why am I doing this 6 by 12 calculation is the periodicity of installment is half yearly. That is every 6 months installment is being paid. And the interest 6% is per annum. 6% is annual interest. But we want to know what is the interest for 6 months. So I am doing this. Normally in other calculations we won't do the 6 by 12 because it will be yearly payment. Here it is half yearly payment, so we are doing this 6 by 12. So 29,800 into 6% into 6 by 12 will give you 894 as your interest. Then installment minus interest will give you cash price paid. We are writing it in the cash price column and we are deducting it from the outstanding balance. 29,800 is outstanding. When you pay the first installment, 7,106 should be deducted from the outstanding balance. Now the outstanding balance is 22,694. The next payment is the second installment. Amount of installment is 8,000. Now your outstanding balance, we have to calculate interest on outstanding balance. the outstanding balance is 22,964. On that value, 6% and 6 by 12, we are calculating to know the half yearly interest. So the half yearly interest is 861. 8000 minus 861 will give you the cash price paid. Now this cash price, we are deducting it from the outstanding balance. 22,694 is the outstanding. 7,319 is the cash price that is paid in the second installment. Deducted, the answer that you get is 15,375. This is the outstanding balance at the end of the second year. Now third installment. Third installment amount is 8,000 rupees. We are calculating interest on the outstanding balance. 15,375 into 6% into 6 by 12. So 8,000 minus interest 461 will give you the cash price. Write it in the cash price column. And again we are deducting it from the outstanding balance. So now the outstanding balance is 7,836. This is the last installment. Fourth installment is the last installment. So I have already told you, for the last installment, we will not calculate percentage. Instead, from the installment amount, we will deduct the outstanding balance. Installment amount la irundha outstanding balance we will deduct it directly. The interest amount is 164. So installment minus interest will give you cash price paid. So after paying the last installment, your balance, outstanding balance, should become zero. This column, second column, will give you the total higher purchase price. 32,000 is the total higher purchase price and 29,800 is the cash price of the asset. So this is with regard to interest calculation. Okay, now before moving on to the ledger accounts, we will see the year in which the buyer has defaulted payment. Okay. So the date on which the asset is purchased is, the asset is purchased on 1/1/1980. So on 1/1/1980, asset is being purchased. Okay, when is the first payment made? The first payment is made on 30 June. 30 June means 36/1980, and it is half yearly payment. January we are purchasing the asset. We are making half yearly payment. So after January, the next payment will become due on 36/1980, as it is given in the question. Half yearly payment, the first installment will become due on 36/1980. When will the second installment become due? After another 6 months. 36/1980, we paid the first installment. The second installment will become due on 31/12/1980. Okay, when will the third installment become due? The third installment will become due on 36/1981, after another 6 months. But this installment, this 36/1981, the third installment was not paid. The buyer defaulted in that installment. See, it is given in the question. It could not pay the installment due on 30 June 1981. So the buyer did not pay this installment. He paid the first installment. He paid the second installment, but he could not pay the third installment. On 36/81, he defaulted payment. Okay, with this information, we will see how to prepare ledger accounts. So the ledger accounts in the books of higher purchaser, that is X Limited. X Limited is the higher purchaser. So in the books of X Limited, we are preparing higher vendor account. Okay. So I have already uploaded another video which talks about how to prepare ledger accounts in the books of higher purchaser and higher vendor without journal. Directly how to prepare ledger accounts, I have already posted the video. The link I have given it in the description box. So do watch that video and then come back for this video for a better understanding. Okay, in that video I explained that in the first year you have only 4 entries: for buying the asset, for making the down payment, interest due, installment due. Okay, so as per that, let's see how to record it. So the first entry, as usual, is for buying the asset. The date of the asset purchased is 1/1/80. Buy machinery account. Machinery account debt to higher vendor account is the journal. So when we post it in the ledger, it will be buy machinery account. In the amount column, we are writing 29,800. This is the cash price of the asset. Okay, after buying the asset, we will make the down payment. In this question, there is no down payment, so we are skipping that transaction. The next is interest due. When will the interest be paid? at the end of the first installment. See here, look here. The first installment is due on 36/19/80. So that is what I have written here. On 36/19/80, interest becomes due. And in the amount column, I am writing the first installment interest amount. Okay. So once the interest becomes due, we will make the payment on the same day. On 36/19/80, we are making payment. First installment amount we are paying. See, the installment amount is 8,000 rupees. It is given in the question. We are writing it in the amount column. First installment amount is paid. Okay. The next installment becomes due in the same year. On January 1980, we are buying the asset. Then within six months, we are paying the first installment. Another 6 months, we are paying the second installment. So it will also come within 1980. So we have to give another interest due entry and payment entry, installment payment entry. So by interest account, this is second installment interest amount. Then 31/12/1980, we are paying the second installment amount. Second installment amount is also 8,000. So in the same year, we have paid two installment. One is on 36/19/80 and the second is on 31/12/1980. Within the same year, we have paid two installments. Okay. Now tally your account and find the balancing figure. Bring down the balancing figure to the next year. We have brought down the balancing figure to the next year. So what happened in the next year? See, look into this calculation here in the at the bottom. On 36/19/81, the hire purchaser defaulted in payment. So he did not pay the third installment. In the year of default, in the installment in which the hire purchaser has defaulted, you have to give the interest due entry, but we will not make the payment entry. Okay. In the installment where the hire purchaser has defaulted, you will give the interest due entry, but you will not give the payment entry. So we are giving the interest due entry. Interest is due on 36/81. Third installment interest amount we are writing. Since the buyer did not make the payment, we are not writing cash. Okay, he did not pay, so we are not writing cash account. But what we are doing, we are calculating the balancing figure. The amount that I have written in the machinery account is nothing but the balancing figure. This is the balancing figure. We are transferring the balancing figure to the machinery account because the machinery is taken back by the hire vendor due to default. So the only thing you should keep in mind for complete reposition problem is, in the event of default, in which installment the hire purchaser has defaulted, you will give the interest due entry. Interest due entry you will give, and you will transfer the balance. You cannot give payment entry because payment has not been made. Don't give payment entry, but transfer the entire balance to the asset account. Whatever balance you have, transfer the entire balance to the asset account. Okay, now let's see how to prepare the asset account. The asset that is being sold here is the machinery. So as I have already told you in my other video, in the machinery account, for the first year, you will have only two entries. Here, since the payment is half yearly, we had two payment entry and two interest entry because the payment is half yearly. But depreciation will be calculated only at the end of every accounting period. Yearly once only we will be calculating depreciation. So for purchasing the asset, you will give one entry to hire vendor account 29,800. This is for buying the asset. At the end of the accounting period, we will charge depreciation. Okay. So depreciation is charged at 10%. Look into the question. 10% depreciation under written down value method. So we are charging depreciation. 29,800 is the cost of the asset into 10 by 100 will give you 2,980 first year depreciation. Tally the accounts. That's all. Only two entries in the first year. Tally your account. Calculate the balancing figure. Bring down the balancing figure to the next year. Next year, 1981. In 1981 only, the hire purchaser has defaulted in payment. When did he default? He defaulted on 36/1981, not whole year, within 6 months itself the payment was due and the buyer did not make the payment. So what should you do? What has been done? The seller took over the asset. The hire vendor took over the asset. But the asset is used by the buyer for 6 months. He used it till 36/1981 and then only the hire vendor is taking back the asset. So you have to charge depreciation in the buyer's books. In the hire purchaser books, we will charge depreciation for 6 months because for 6 months the asset is used in his business. So we will charge depreciation for 6 months. So by depreciation account, since this is written down value method, on the balance 29,680, on that balance we are charging depreciation at 10% and we are charging it only for 6 months. Why only for 6 months? After the 6th month, the seller takes back the asset. So only for 6 months the asset is used by the buyer, only for 6 months we are charging depreciation. The amount of depreciation is 1341. Then in the machinery, in the hire vendor account, we have calculated one balancing figure which is transferred to machinery account. That amount only I am transferring here. See, in the hire vendor's books, I highlighted for you, in the hire vendor account we are transferring one amount to the machinery account, isn't it? Now we are preparing machinery account. So in this machinery account, we are bringing this balance, this balancing figure, the amount that is being transferred, 15,836, we have transferred. That 15,836 we are bringing here by hire vendor account. We are transferring it from the hire vendor account. From hire vendor account, we are transferring to machinery account. Because this is the value of goods that is taken by the hire vendor on default. Okay, and after this you tally your account, find out the balancing figure. This balancing figure will be transferred to profit and loss account. Henceforth the machinery does not exist with us. Since the buyer defaulted in payment, the seller took over the machinery, so we cannot show any balancing figure in the machinery account. Whatever is the balancing figure, that balancing figure must be transferred to profit and loss account. Here the balancing figure is 9,643. So we are transferring this balancing figure to P&L account. We cannot show any balance in the machinery account. No, the machinery is taken back by the seller. So no machinery exists with us. We have to close this machinery account by transferring balance to profit and loss account. Okay. Okay. Now let's move on and see how to work out ledger accounts in the books of the hire vendor. So ledger accounts in the books of the hire vendor. In the hire vendor's book, the account that we open is hire purchaser. In this question, the hire purchaser is X Limited, so we are opening X Limited account. Okay, as I already told you in my previous video, in the first year we will have 4 entries. Now we are looking into the seller's point of view, for selling the asset, for receiving down payment, interest becoming due and receiving installment amount. Okay, first the asset is sold. On what date the asset is sold? On 1st January 1980. So on 1/1/1980, two hire sales. Because here the ownership of the asset is not transferred in hire purchase agreement. So the entry will be X Limited account debtor, two hire sales account. In the amount column, write the cash price of the asset. Then down payment. Here in this problem, there is no down payment. The hire purchaser is not giving any down payment, so no need to give entry for that. Then interest. So when does the interest become due? As I already explained you, interest become due on half yearly rest. On 36/80, interest becomes due. First installment interest. Write the amount in the amount column. On the same day, first installment amount is received by cash account, first installment account. Then second installment becomes due on 31/12/1980. So write the second installment interest amount. On the same day, second installment amount is received. Tally your accounts, find the balancing figure, bring the balancing figure to the next year. Next year we are bringing down the balancing figure. In the next year, in the third installment, the buyer did not make payment. So as I already told you, in the installment where the payment is not made, where the buyer did not make the payment, you have to give interest due entry Cash received entry we will not give. So we are charging interest due entry on 36/1981. Interest is due. Write the third installment interest amount. Cash is not received, so we cannot give by cash here. Instead, what we are doing? The seller, we are taking back the stock. Buyer did not make payment, so the hire vendor is taking back the machinery that is being sold. So transfer the whole balance, actually the balancing figure only, we are transferring it to repossessed stock account. The seller, the hire vendor, is taking back the goods on default by the buyer. So the total amount is transferred to repossessed stock account. So I hope you understood how to calculate repossessed stock account, how to do ledger accounts in the books of the hire purchaser and hire vendor when there is default and complete repossession. The next concept is partial repossession. For that, I have uploaded a video, another video. Look into the description box, I have given the link. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching.